Wow, what a ride, right? What a fantastic film. So, director Liao, the original title in Chinese is Love Nightmare. And your dreams have a dreamlike, your films have a dreamlike quality. What are good dreams and bad dreams? How do they directly and indirectly influence your work?
这部片的中文的片名就是直翻的话叫做《Love Nightmare》，就是爱的噩梦。那整场电影感觉上就像一场梦一样。那为什么会有动用这样的方式？是直接的，或是非直接的，想要表达什么样的？要么是噩梦，要么是梦幻的好的梦呢？是怎么会用梦这个东西来做一个元素？梦有谁吗？
梦在我人生中占很重要的部分。我大概这一次吃安眠药大概是2015年，因为我这次要来美国嘛，我就去申请了那个医药证明，就发现我是从2015年一直一路吃药到现在，所以我长期失眠的问题，所以梦在我人生中是重要的一环。然后我大概。 如果梦分成三等份，我大概有三分之一的等份，就是我醒来的过程都是在梦里面透过死亡的方式醒来的，所以梦在我人生中很重要。So
dreams to me actually is pretty important this time because of this trip to somehow get used to and get over the jet lag. I actually got a prescription for melatonin, and then that's when I realized that actually I've been taking sleep aids for many, many years since 2005.
是05还是15?
2015. So for me, I have been having a hard time falling asleep, and sleep issues is definitely something I deal with on a daily basis. And one third of my waking hours, so if I have 24 hours and that I have a hard time falling asleep, I will be thinking about what happened in my dreams. And sometimes, most of times when I wake up, it's when death happened, and that's when I wake up. So yes, so this is definitely something that's very close to home.
So do any of the parts of your stories come directly from dreams you had?
那是不是从自己确实的做过的梦去找到一些灵感和一些细节？没有啊。No。大部分还是对于爱情的想法啦，因为这部基本上是一个爱情的电影嘛，吼。然后我们只是借由梦让男子有机会可以换一个女朋友，可基本上要讨论的东西还是爱情啊。
So very much at the core, this film is about romance. It's about love. I'm using dreams as a device to let the male character to have different women to have a relationship with.
That's a perfect segue for my next question. So in both your features, they're basically describing doomed love. The relationships start off sweet. Sometimes they get very sweet. Then they turn sour. Where does this penchant for trouble in love come from?
那这些片的大部分都是一开始都很甜蜜，到最后就是很悲剧的方式收场。那我怎么会有这样子一个倾向？就是对于爱情的观念，就是结尾是不好的。没有不好，就是我觉得爱情是真正的爱情的部分在。 一对恋人的关系里面，爱情的部分我觉得很短暂。我所谓的爱情的部分，就是对方没有说你也愿意为他做事情，你没说他也愿意为你做事情，那一段时间叫做爱情，就是我们俗称的热恋期。可是经过那一段时间之后，就不叫爱情了吗？就是我们没有别的两个字可以替代，所以基本上它也是叫爱情。可是它已经转化成别的情感了，就是你为什么没有来接我？ 你干嘛来接你？你没有脚啊？就这样就不爱你了吗？不一定哦。所以这部片是在讨论的是一个男生遇到爱情问题的时候，他选择逃避。对，是这样一个故事。
So for me, I really think that the honeymoon period of any romance of love, they're very, very short-lived. And if you think about the beginning of the relationship, you didn't even have to ask that people will actually willingly, voluntarily offer whatever they want to do with their partners. But that might end very, very quickly. Then we'll be to a point that, why didn't you pick me up? Because you didn't ask. So that sort of turned into something that is other than the honeymoon period of romance. It is completely different emotions and relationships. So for me, I just think that this is something that the decision this particular character need to make. If this happened to you, what will be your decision? What will the options that you choose? Or do you just decide to ignore it or to avoid it? So that's very much at the core of this film.
A very practical worldview, but a very unorthodox storytelling. I'm going to have another question for you, and then we're going to do a group question. Your world building is fantastic. It's both naturalistic and surreal. How do you achieve this, whether it's location shooting, or it's through wardrobe, or production design, or VFX, or just your imagination? How do you create these places?
那你拍布这部片的时候，对于创造一个这样子想要建筑的世界或构筑的世界，然后就做得很到底。那是用什么样的方式可以让大家可以进入这样的一个你创作出来的这样的空间？到底是透过你选景的地点，透过你服装的设计，还是透过什么样一些巧妙的安排，可以让大家在这样不一样的世界，你构筑出来的多元宇宙里面可以有自由的穿梭？
就我觉得视觉的东西，还是需要每个部门都整合，就是不管是摄影、服装，或者是你制作的场景，或者是你选择租借的场景，我觉得在这个东西会有一套系统。然后这一套系统，基本上就是，比如说，就如果在场有。 台湾以外的朋友，就他看到他如果只看到这部电影，他就会觉得台湾是长这样，所以这个是我们选择放在这部片里面的台湾的样子，然后又要可以符合出现奇怪，可是又不会导致太奇怪。像就是我的前一个影展是去韩国，我发现韩国跟台湾长超像的，可是韩国的电影。 它有一个韩国电影的样子，你一看就知道，所以它是选择性的提供你观众可以看到的韩国，所以这部片也是一样，这个是在我这部片里面想要提供出来的台湾的场景，比较都会一点，对。
So for me, this is the visual aesthetics and decisions that I have to make, and they have to work so well together in such an integrated way and a comprehensive way in order for this to really, really click, including the cinematography, including costumes, including location, the space that I choose to shoot my scenes. So I think very much to create a system that will somehow reflect or really goes into the imaginations of the people who are not Taiwanese. This will be the Taiwan that they know. This is the Taiwan they think they know, and they will see it, and it will feel so authentic for them. And before this film actually was in the International Film Festival in Korea, I found Korea was so similar in terms of landscape, cityscape with Taiwan. But at the same time, if you look at the Korean films, there is a specific, unique Koreanness that actually being packaged and being represented in such a way that they will really, you will resonate with that, you can identify that this is from Korea. So that's pretty much the way that I think about my aesthetics and the decision I make for many production decisions come into play for this movie.
Excellent answer. I have a quick technical question. Was it iPhone 14, 15, 12?
手机是哪一个世代？
是 14。
Okay, so this question is for all of you, and it's related. What are the advantages, and also what are the limitations of shooting a feature film on iPhone? Director, would you like to take that first?
用苹果手机或者手机来拍片的就是长处或者短处是或者哪些挑战？可以讲一下。
就很轻啊。
Very lightweight.
That's all?
就这样吗
？Yeah.
Yes.
What about budget and crew?
哦，预算啊，对。
啊，这个问题比较好回答。用 iPhone 拍一定会在某一个预算框架里面。就简单说，我不可能拿 iPhone 去拍侏罗纪公园，那不合理。所以 iPhone 的出现会服务一些中小型的电影，因为现在电影制作其实越来越昂贵，电影有一定的门槛高度。那自从相机出现、手机出现之后，我们可以把门槛降低。就好像其实人手大家都会有一支铅笔，可是不一定每个人都可以把图画得很好，或每个人都可以自称是画家。可是现在至少你的口袋里面就有摄影机，要不要成为电影制作者是你的选择，跟你是否要努力去练习，而不是有一个门槛是我就没有那个机器，所以我做不了那个职位。没有，现在那个机器就在你口袋里面，那你要不要往那边努力是你的选择。
So for me, in terms of budget, it will be unwise or impossible for me to shoot a film using cell phone or iPhones, let's say Jurassic Park, for example. That's just, it doesn't go. And for me, this is very fitting for medium or smaller scale films. And really, because of this technology, it makes it so accessible for people who want to and choose to make film, they will be able to. The threshold in terms of budget, in terms of money, will be much, much lower than the traditional unconventional camera that you need to have in order for you to make films. Just like the same way that now pencil is so accessible that everyone can use that to draw, but doesn't mean that everyone can be a painter. But similarly for the phone, you have a camera in your pocket right now. If you want to be a filmmaker, you can. And that's, it has become so accessible that this become a possibility for anyone who wants to make film to be able to do.
Excellent. Okay, so Austin, do you have anything to add as far as advantage and disadvantage of shooting iPhone?
这是我们第二次用 iPhone 拍电影，然后上一次怪胎是因为描述了跟强迫症有关的故事跟角色，所以导演在拍摄的角度啊，或者是使用的画幅，就前面是正方形，后面是长方形的，其实都有跟这个电影的主题有非常紧密的结合。那这一次导演也换了另外一个方式在使用 iPhone。其实我觉得他在《爱的噩梦》里面，我看起来觉得他感觉你完全不会觉得哦，这是一个手机拍出来的电影，它其实就是一个很一般的摄影机的样子。所以我其实看到大荧幕的时候，我是觉得非常惊艳的。那也在我觉得在拍摄上，其实。因为手机很小一台，所以你其实不太会感觉到它的存在，所以对表演来说是还蛮自在的。不过除此之外，好像没有特别觉得表演上有什么太多的不一样。对，所以我可能不会说哪一个好，哪一个不好，而是就是导演在不同的器材的选择而已。对啊。
So this is the second time I actually participated in a film made completely, entirely using iPhone. The first one was I Weirdo, and that is a story very much about someone who is suffering from OCD, or two of them actually. And I think there's a reason to actually use this particular technology, not only the angles that the director choose to shoot this film, but also the aspect ratios to tell a story, to a narrative structure, to go from the square aspect ratio to the rectangle aspect spatial aspect ratio. So it is a very calculated and also very thoughtful way of thinking about how can I use this particular device to make a film and tell a story that I want to tell. So for Suffocating Love, I do think that what surprised me the most is when I look at the final film on screen, you cannot really tell that this is a film made by iPhones or any type of smartphone device. So it is something that is not only surprising, but also I have to give kudos to the director to make it so seamlessly. And for me, as an actor, to have something that is so lightweight and so small, to work with that particular device that I didn't even feel the existence, the presence of the camera when I'm performing in front of it. So that made me very at ease, very comfortable, and I don't think that I changed the way I perform. Therefore, for me, there's no whether or not it's better, whether or not it's worse, whether or not it's strength or weaknesses. To me, it's definitely the choice that the director make, and then there's a reason for him to make that particular decision.
是什么？就是用手机拍的这样好处。哦，以演员的方式来看，好处跟我觉得，我就以第一支我们怪胎好了。怪胎那时候我其实很不习惯，因为我是第一次被手机用手机拍摄，然后我当下感觉我只觉得导演离我好近，然后机器很小。 因为我们如果以往都是用大机器，然后后面是摄影师，导演一般通常都是在猫的后面，所以我是第一次在导演的面前演戏，我会有一种很赤裸的感觉，就是他会随时纠正你的那种感觉，对我来说压力很大。那但是因为我们怪胎结束之后，其实。 我们三个的默契都已经非常好了，所以我们在拍《爱的噩梦》的时候，我觉得已经可以把那种赤裸的感觉给抽掉，更多的反而是信任感。所以在《爱的噩梦》里面，我跟柏宏的那一场就是床戏，然后前面还有一个我站在那边穿很少的那个。 其实那一颗镜头是因为基本上要拍那些拍那种戏都会清场，但是再怎么清场，如果是大机器的话，旁边都还会有摄影师，还有一个收音师，然后可能还有一个副导。但是我们拍这一场戏是只有导演跟一台手机，一台嘛，对不对？一台。对，就一台手机，所以对我来说是一个非常放心的状态。 然后，即便是跟柏宏在床上的那个也是，就是非常的净空，对，很自在。哦，对不起。对，嗯，我是说我自己的感觉了。So
I can share with you my experience being shot with iPhone for the entire film for the first time, which is I Weirdo. And at that time, I was not used to being shot with someone holding an iPhone or holding just a very small camera, because that makes me feel as if that I'm so naked in front of the director, because there's nothing in between us. The iPhone is so small, and then the director is literally in your face. So to me, it gave me a lot of pressure in terms of as if I'm acting for him, and also that means that the director can correct me very, very easily with very close proximity. So I felt very, very naked. Now, when we started this particular project, it's the second time. Since the experience I had with I Weirdo with the three of us, I have come to know how we work together, and not only we become very, very close as professional relationship wise and the collaboration we have wise, we also built a lot of trust because of the first film. So I didn't feel as naked as a result. So for the scenes such as the sex scenes I had with Austin, even when I'm wearing very scampy outfit. And in the past, if you have that particular big camera, which that means that the director usually hide behind the monitor, and then you have to clear the room, but still you will have people holding the microphone, you have assistant directors still there, and it is not a very, very free, carefree environment for me. But because of this one, we are only using one cell phone as a camera. And I just feel very at ease and very comfortable in combination with the trust I already have with everyone in this production. So that was, these two films have completely different experience with the same device.
Great answers. Okay, we're going to take some audience questions. Let's see what we can do. They had two questions that were similar, and it is, why is his dream lover not the girl who is his high school classmate? Anyone want to answer that? Go ahead.
为什么第三段的这个梦中的情人不是他高中的时候那个前女友？
Anybody?
那个我如果有珍妮佛劳伦斯可以选，我是不会选我邻居的。好。
So if I have the choice between a neighbor or ex-lover in high school and Jennifer Lawrence, I would definitely choose Jennifer Lawrence.
所以他是一个在梦里面，其实男生并没有讲出他要选择谁，那个是梦的那个把关者给他潜意识他最想要的女人，所以就是珍妮佛劳伦斯哈。
So if you pay attention to the scene into the dream sequence with the dream lover, you didn't really see how he made a wish that this is what I want. He just woke up with someone sleeping next to him. So I am tapping more into the subconscious of this particular character and the decision that sort of came out of that, and that is the Jennifer Lawrence of the character that's sitting right next to me right now. Yes.
Great. I take it you both agree with that.
都同意吗?
Yes.
Yeah, he's the director.
Okay. All right. But it is your character. Okay. For Austin, as an actor, do you prefer movies or television dramas, and why?
比较喜欢电影还是电视影集？为什么？
对我来说，我觉得好像不会特别去分电影或是影集。那尤其现在的观看作品的平台这么多，然后我们每天都在Netflix 上面。有时候看电影，有时候看影集，所以对我来说更重要的是有没有从这个作品当中得到感动，或者是我在看剧本的时候有没有觉得哇，我好像可以理解这个角色的某一部分，或者是我有没有对这个角色有一个很提供我个人比较 personal 的状态，或者是连结在里面，对啊。
So for me, I don't really make a distinction between whether or not this is a TV production or a TV series I'm a part of or a movie, because right now when people watch something, they watch on different platforms, and you could be watching TV series and movie on the same platform. So for me, the most important thing, the project that I want to participate in will be the ones that really move me. And also for me to be able to understand the characters of that particular project, and also whether or not I can find personal connection with either the story, the film, or the characters that, that I have to portray. So those are just the criteria that I would decide whether or not I want to participate in particular projects.
Let me ask a question to Nikki. Your character is kind of complex. What did you find relatable, and what did you find challenging?
你的角色其实非常复杂的一个角色，那你觉得这个角色跟你自己本身有什么很相同的地方可以共情的地方，还是有什么很多不完全不一样的地方可以多提一下？
好像也没有什么复杂的耶，因为我先说，我觉得我跟角色最像的就是迷信的部分。因为我也很喜欢去拜拜，或是求神问卜这样，但说到不像的，可能就是因为黑泽她在男子眼中是一个100分的女朋友， 那我觉得100分要做到100分的另外一半有一点太困难了，然后甚至是他要非常的女人味，然后甚至是白嘉琪没有办法给他的东西，我会尽全力的给予他。我觉得这些对我来说是谢欣颖不会做的事，所以这个跟我是不一样的。
So for me, I don't really think that this particular character is very, very complicated. I understand her. And for me, the closest thing that between the character and myself in real life is that we are both very superstitious. I pray temples, and then I will do fortune telling. So that's very similar. But the aspect of this character Yuri Kurosawa that to be so 100% in a perfect idealistic lover or dreamboat for this particular male character, and to do everything I can or she can, Yuri's character, to meet the needs of Austin in this film, the character and the male character, and to also provide anything that they've missed by, which is the first girlfriend that couldn't provide, and do it so eagerly, 100%. That's just not me in real life. Myself as a person, it's not something that I would do, not the decision that I will make.
Another great answer, and that also segues into this audience question. The movie has superstitious elements. What inspired you to include the superstitions?
为什么会把迷信的这个环节把它加到电影里面去当作一个元素？
因为第一段那个控制欲的部分，基本上都还是在写实的状态，就是透过手机想要控制男友回报之类的，然后第二个女生、第三者，这个也都是在一般感情里面会出现的比较真实的东西，只是我们把它戏剧化。那所以当他换女友，而且换到一个完美的女友的时候，显然他背后那个不为人知的秘密，就是我们所谓恐怖的地方，需要超过写实。那在台湾就是，不管你是不是有真的有信所谓佛教、道教，你工作人生不顺的时候，或许都会去庙里拜一下拜，抽个签之类的。哦，所以我们就用了迷信这个，在台湾大家都会知道，而我不需要再告诉大家一次这个规则是什么的东西，所以就用一个极度迷信的女人，在得到她想要的男人这样。
So for me to incorporate that into the film is because the way I structure the films, you have three parts. The first part and the second part, they are more or less reflecting the reality. It's realism based. The first one, you have someone who is a control freak, and she has the issue about wanting to control the boyfriend, and whether or not it's using the iPhones, when it's to keep on checking on his whereabouts. The second one about the affair. It's also basing in terms of realism that this is a very well-known or common issues that the lovers or couples are dealing with. For the third one, since this is the finale of the film in such a way that I need to create something that will, it will be stronger and more intense with this idea of this idea of being controlled or to control someone. So I need to really find an element that will be very different from the first and the second, and also will be greater and more intense in degree. So I thought about the supernatural, or the surreal elements of the, this big secrets that she's holding to control her boyfriend. And I think that this is very common for people in Taiwan, or most of the Asian people will have either rituals that they practice. They might not be the believer or devotees of Buddhism or Taoism, but these are the common rituals they will practice to pray, to have certain sort of religious rituals that they are part of to somehow get what they want, or they will have the prayers, the answers through that way. So I thought that this would be a very easy way for the Taiwanese audience to look at this and understand the protocol, understand the reason behind what she's doing, and I don't need to really explain too much because they already have that frame of reference, and this is something that we practice on a daily basis or on a regular basis. So that's the reason why this is one of the elements.
I think we have time for one more. I have a question in Chinese. Can we try it? Can I pass it to you?
Sure.
Or you want to read it?
电影里的画幅等同于下降头吗?
So the question was the aspect ratio of the film, is it something that will reflect the actual reality of this particular black magic practice called the tame head?
方法是自创的还是真实的呢?
And this is something that is originally all your invention, or this is something that maybe
还是跟专业的人工学习的呢?
Maybe some kind of artificial intelligence that you somehow rely on?
好，那个我没有去研究泰国的那个下降头，所以。 我不知道下降头详细的做法是什么，可是就是我们这一套做法。
So I'm not very familiar with the black magic practice mostly in Southeast Asia called the tame head. So no, that's not the reason why I decided that particular aspect ratio.
我们这一套做法就是我每年都会跟我妈妈去两次庙里面的做法。
So what I'm doing with this film is the rituals I practice with my mother twice a year to go to the temple to pray and to worship.
那为了让我妈妈高兴呢，我都会去哦。虽然我本人没有那么相信，可是我们在里面，比如说符咒，那个符咒是一个观音求子的符咒，就所以我们有可能它有一个侧面的秘密，就是黑泽他想要。 求子，这是在符咒里面可以解读的秘密。这样，然后那些火烧符咒啊、撒盐啊，这些都是真实会这样做的。
So for me is to go with my with my mother to the temple to make her happy, even though that I'm not really a believer of it. I just do it to appease my mother. So in the film, the practice of using the talisman, and you have scriptures and the writing on it, is pretty much just saying that this is a talisman to pray for offspring through the blessing of the goddess of mercy. So in such a way that I'm trying to also hopefully point out that this is actually her wish, her prayer is to have a son or have a daughter, have an offspring. And that is, you know, the practice of either using, you know, burning the talisman, burning the joss paper, the salt practice. Those are very, very familiar rituals that we practice in Taiwan.
Wow, great. Well, I think that's all the time we have. Thank you so much. Wonderful film.